on the phone with us all the way from San Antonio, Texas. One of the best champions in boxing, Joshua Franco, the professor. Josh, how are you feeling today?
Good, good. What about you?
I'm always good. I never have a bad day.
Hell yeah, hell yeah.
We give other people bad days. I'm joking, of course. But I wanted to ask you, listen, you're a very well-mannered person. You're very humble. You're a family man. You're quiet. You fight Maloney in a rematch, and all of a sudden, the entire world, not only the boxing world, everybody has an opinion about you. And you're not the judge. You're not the commission. You're a boxer and a champion. So I want you to tell everybody, because no one's really heard from you since your fight with Maloney. It was two rounds. It was a headbutt, and the fight stopped. What happened in the ring that night?
Well, in the first round, I got a headbutt from Maloney because he was using his head a lot. And my eye started to swell up, and the ref had said it was a headbutt. So, I mean, after the second round, when the third round was going to start, the ref called the doctor, and the doctor asked if I could see. I couldn't see it anymore. You know, even after the first round, I couldn't see. And I told him, no, I couldn't see because I couldn't. He was holding a finger that I couldn't see. And that's when he decided to call a fight. But, I mean, it wasn't my fault. It wasn't my call. It was the ref and the doctor's call. I mean, there's not really much I could do about it. Just, you know, can't do much.
Yeah, and then Maloney and his team got very heated. I mean, I don't know why they're mad. Why they're mad at you. What do you have to do with it? You in the ring. What do you say about their responses? His coach is posting today. Maloney's going everywhere. Says, I got robbed. They took it away from me.
I mean, it was only two rounds. How was he happy with just throwing pity pat punches in the first two rounds? You don't want a championship belt with just doing that. I'm the champion. You know, when I fought him, I went in his backyard and I took his belt. And you know, I was the opponent against the promoter, and I still fought through it and I still came out on top. I mean, he didn't prove nothing that night. It was only two rounds. He didn't do anything. They're saying, oh, he won. He should have won the belt, whatever. It was only two rounds.
I don't know him personally, so I don't know if he's a good dude. I don't know him, but I can't say anything bad about him either because I don't know him. But
yeah, I know.
But here's what I'm going to say. You got in the ring the first time, you took his title. The second time it was this mishap. You got hit. We all saw the clip and the angle that showed him the head collision. It looked accidental, but I don't know if it was an accident or not, right?
Yeah.
But they didn't show that on TV for some reason. Why do you think they didn't show it on TV?
Well, because they were trying to protect their fighter. You know, he's a top-ranked fighter. He was the name on ESPN. So, of course, they wanted to protect him and, you know, make him look good. But they didn't want to show the other clips that the other people have posted.
And I think that's what the commission saw. And that's why the commission ruled it an accidental headbutt.
But I think he was really mad because we're probably gonna have to rematch now. And I honestly think he didn't want to fight me again. He knows you know what I have, and I know he knows. I mean, there's nothing you can do about it now. We're gonna have to fight again.
Yeah, it's the rubber match. Are you ready to pack your suitcases and head to Australia?
I mean, we'll see where it's gonna happen.
You know, of course.
Anywhere.
Yeah,
I love to fight.
Yeah, no, I asked Teofimo Lopez the same question. Do you think you could win in Australia without a knockout, or do you have to have a knockout to win?
Probably not. You probably have to knock him out and, you know, make him look really messed up.
So,
you know, to get that win.
So I talked to Robert Garcia, of course, and Pita and everybody, and they said that on fight night, you were very cool. Like, when everybody's tempers were flaring, you were just a cucumber. You were chilling.
Yeah.
Why? Why didn't you get mad? Why didn't you get upset?
I mean, it wasn't my call. First off, you know, I couldn't really do nothing about it. You know, I mean, even if I did get mad, what's gonna? I mean, nothing's gonna change from me getting mad. So why get mad? You know, just live to fight another day.
That's true. Have you spoken to Maloney or his team since the fight? Did they talk to you after the fight or something?
Nah, I mean, I haven't talked to them at all. Just honestly, I never talked to them before. But I know Maloney stays looking at my Instagram stories all the time.
Do you have anything to tell him if he's listening or watching this?
So that has to be ready. because I want him to show me whatever he was looking spectacular about in the second fight. And, oh, he was looking so good. Well, hey, well, show me the third fight then and be ready for it.
Why do you think his team say there was no headbutt when we all saw the headbutt in that replay?
I mean, they wanted to get the win, so of course they're going to say, oh, it was a punch or it was a 50 jabs he was landing. He's such a power puncher and, you know, he hurt me or whatever, supposedly.
Yeah, but I'll be honest with you. I'm not a big believer in all those statistics because many times, I'll be honest with you, I've been watching boxing for many, many years. You'll see the A-sider, the superstar, barely land one punch. And then when they do the statistics that come up, you always see the B-side fighter barely threw, barely landed. And the other guy threw 1,000 and landed 999.
Yeah. Yep.
So I can't really give a lot of, you know, I can't take it seriously because numbers you can manipulate easy. Bottom line is, the first fight you won clearly by a wide margin and they almost robbed you. If you didn't drop him, it would have been a draw. And the second fight, obviously, you can hear the ref in the 2:08 of the first round saying, hey, accidental headbutt. He tells it to the commission, correct?
Yeah.
Did you have a chance to watch it again, or you haven't watched it yet, the second fight?
Yeah, I had watched it. I had watched it again a couple of times.
So what was going through your mind when you watched it?
I mean, just what, the same thing that everybody saw, the headbutt, you know, and... What I also saw was the same way he started the first fight was the same exact way he started the second fight, and it was just gonna get worse for him as the rounds were going on. It was just gonna get worse for him.
I saw some people online and some of the broadcasters, and maybe his team said, "Oh, it was the jab that caused the swelling." But Pete and Robert told me the swelling started from the headbutt right away. Tell me about it from your perspective.
Yeah, it was from the headbutts. You know, he was coming in with his head a lot. I mean, I wasn't complaining because, you know, we're fighting, but, you know, the ref caught it, and, you know, that's his job. So, you know, he caught the headbutt. And my job is to fight, so I just keep on fighting until the ref says something. You know, my focus is, you know, to do the fighting.
It's funny because in your short career, you experienced so much. You were undefeated. You went to Puerto Rico. You were winning a fight. You actually got robbed in Puerto Rico. Ref stopped it super fast when you were up by like a million points in that fight. And then you come back. You have a trilogy. You win the title. And now you're about to do another trilogy. I don't think anybody in modern day has had two trilogies in 17, 18 fights.
Yeah, that's true. All of those fights that, you know, I had a couple draws. I had the loss in Puerto Rico. It matured me. It matured me mentally as well. You know, nothing really affects me anymore. I've been through a lot of shit in the sport. So, I mean, nothing new to me.
And that's it. So right now you're resting. You're feeling good. Everything okay health wise?
Yeah, everything's good. You know, my eyes are already hitting up, and I'm just as soon as I get to okay, I'm gonna be back to the gym already. And, you know. Gonna get ready for the next one.
And we're talking to Joshua Franco, the boxing star. Of course, he just fought Andrew Maloney. Obviously, your friends from the gym all support you. Did you get any support from other people in boxing that maybe we didn't see it publicly, but they reached out to you and said, hey, don't worry, you won, or this was dirty, or we saw it?
Yeah, you know, I got some support from, you know, different people. I mean, but most of it was fucking just... Excuse my language, but most of it was just hate, you know? People were just hating on me. And not hate, but they were just mad because I stayed with the belt. But it's not even my fault. It's not my call. It's just, it's the commission's call. So, I mean.
It's a commission call, but at the same time, if there was a headbutt, then, hey, it's part of boxing. It happens, and these are the rules. Yeah. So, let me ask you, switch gears for a second. Danny Garcia, Errol Spence, break it down.
I'm going to say what you say. The fans are the winners, but... That's going to be a good fight. For sure, I'm going to be tuned into that one.
And then, that's a big one. Then, Canelo's coming to San Antonio. He's fighting Colin Smith. What do you think?
That's going to be a badass fight. You know, Canelo's going to win. And it's going to be in San Antonio, so I know it's going to be a good crowd. And, you know, it's a boxing city, so it's going to be dope.
That's true. And then your brother's fighting December 12th, that's correct?
Yes.
Bam, he's in camp right now in San Antonio. What can we expect from his fight?
what you always see from Bam, you know, nothing but fireworks. That's all he does. That's all he knows how to create his fireworks whenever he fights.
We need to talk.
He's looking strong in the gym, training hard and sparring. It's going good. You know, he was already in shape since camp, since over there. So he's just, you know, keeping the rhythm and, you know, so he won't lose his shape or lose his conditioning.
Absolutely. And I know you mentioned fireworks. We got to talk to Neno to make him a really exclusive ring entrance with a bunch of fireworks.
Yeah, that'd be dope. I think Neno's fighting the same day, December 12th.
Well, Neno, he's going to have little sparkles.
Yeah.
I'm just joking. Neno's a knockout artist as well. You have it's going to be a good night, December 12th, ESPN. Are you going to be there to come support him?
Yeah, I'll be there. I'll be in Vegas.
That would be amazing. So there you have it. Josh, tell people where to follow you on Twitter and Instagram.
You can follow me on Twitter at @JoshuaFranco_ and Instagram at @ProfessorFranco.
And Josh, one last question. You're a very nice person. You don't even jaywalk. They call you the professor. How does someone like you, who's always been everyone's favorite from the amateurs, everyone always talked about Josh, how do you handle in one moment when so many people are hating and it's not even your fault, you didn't even do anything? How do you handle it as an athlete, as a star, as a person?
You just got to, you know, ignore it. Ignore it and stay true to yourself, know yourself, and, you know, just keep all that bad stuff away. I mean, there's no need to pay any attention to it. Why pay it? Attention to it, what's it gonna do for me, you know? So why even give it any attention? Just ignore it and, you know, go on with it. Who cares?
That's true. Message to your fans if they were listening.
Appreciate the support. Thank you everybody who supports me, and, you know, keep supporting me. You're only gonna see better fights, and I'm gonna keep my belt, and still, you already know how it goes. And I appreciate you, Ellie, for calling me.
No, of course. No problem. Anytime, man. We'll see you soon. There you have it, Joshua Franco. Make sure to follow him. Stay tuned. The rubber match, the third fight with Andrew Maloney. Let's see what happens. Maybe next fight you need a fight with a helmet. I'm just playing. Ellie Segback, reporting.